Очков, мужики. Все сгорело. Все, что можно, нахуй нельзя. Все машины, одна перевернута. Не знаю, каким она образом перевернулась. Колина. Машины ничего не осталось. Шестерка. Ничего не осталось, пацаны. Сейчас еще внутрь. Патроны вроде все, но прошли. Попробую зайти. Сюда вот никого не осталось. Силовенько, давайте.
Три машины на одной купол за 400 рублей куплены, блядь, своими деньгами, блядь. Пизда, просто пизда, ебать, просто пизда, нахуй. Блять, новый генератор, ебать, сука, у расчета вещей нет, все, нихуя нету, блять, три машины, нахуй, по пизде, пизда, я не знаю, патроны взрываются. Я текать нахуй.
Да. Короче, мужики, все посмотрел. Вот она, Серега, твоя четырка. Вон она, нахуй. Колина, твоя четырка. Шестерка. Ничего, ребят, не осталось. Вот генератор новый. Все. Вообще все пусто. Никакой хуйни не осталось. От слова совсем. От слова совсем. Ничего, пацаны, не осталось.
Ukrainian Defense Forces began their invasion of Russia's Kursk region on August the 6th, and over the course of that month, the Kursk operation has significantly changed the situation on the front line, as military expert and retired Ukrainian Army Colonel Roman Svitan noted in a commentary to Channel 24, the Ukrainian military now has the ability to tie down the Russians even more. According to him, the Kursk operation changed the architecture of military operations, creating a new northern front. We have finally turned towards the enemy. Now we have the northern front. That's how it should have been, the expert noted. According to him, how events will develop in the Kursk region will depend on the number of troops that the Russian command will transfer there. At the same time, the Ukrainian armed forces will be able to tie down thousands of troops of Russians in this area. The Kursk operation could go from control to tying down the Russians. Then we will tie up hundreds of thousands of Russian troops if they decide to stop us, Svitan said. He also stressed that the Ukrainian military needs to carry out strikes towards Moscow and not stop moving in this direction. Then, according to the expert, the Russians will be even more confused. Commander-in-Chief of the Armed Forces of Ukraine, Oleksandr Sirsky, said in an interview with CNN that the Ukrainian Armed Forces offensive in the Kursk region has slowed down the Russian army's advance in the Pokrovsk sector. Everything possible is being done to ensure that the town of Pokrovsk is not lost. Defenses are being strengthened there. Of course, the enemy has concentrated his best trained units in the Pokrovsk direction, but we have deprived him of the opportunity to maneuver his units and redeploy his reinforcement units from other areas, said Sirsky. He noted that despite the fact that Russia has not moved many troops from the Pokrovsk region, with the exception of one Marine brigade, the enemy can no longer maneuver reserves as before. As a result, the enemy's pressure is easing in other areas. According to Sirsky, the number of artillery attacks and the intensity of offensive actions have decreased. The Pokrovsk direction remains the most problematic for us. In other areas, the situation has become more stable. Therefore, I believe that this strategy was chosen correctly and will bring us the desired result, he concluded. As a reminder, Mykola Melnik, a company commander of the 47th Separate Mechanized Brigade, recently stated that there is no stabilization in the Pokrovsk sector and that Russian invaders continue to advance.